Ladies and gentlemen, you probably have felt ouch when you saw Soilbuild REIT propose privatization, right? Especially if you are a Soilbuild shareholder. Let's look into it. Why? Now, what is true, ladies and gentlemen, is that from the presentation slide, you can see that Soilbuild has actually told you that if you have been their faithful shareholder since IPO at a price of 78 cents, you know, and invested, say, $1 million, the price, the way it has moved, you would have lost 45% of the value, meaning that you have put in $1 million, you'll be down $450,000. Huge, huge loss for investment into a REIT, where REIT or real investment, estate investment trust, is supposed to give you steady income and good growth. So what went wrong? You know, now, mind you, Soilbuild has mentioned that they have actually done quite a few things to help shareholders by the sale of assets, that is actually KTL Offshore as well as 72 Loyang Way. Now, in actual fact, if you read my book, ladies and gentlemen, on page, now, this is my book, ladies and gentlemen, is Making Your Millions in REITs. And on page 116, I just want to tell you what is 72 Loyang Way. Now, 72 Loyang Way, in my book, you know, per the description that Soilbuild has mentioned, is that the property is an integrated facility comprising two blocks of three-story and four-story ancillary office. Two ceiling single production facilities, a blasting and spray painting chamber, a 200 worker dormitory, a blasting and spray painting chamber, and a jetty with 142 meters of sea frontage. Wow. You know, ladies and gentlemen, sea frontage, okay? But so what happened, therefore, with the sea frontage, 72 Loyang Way actually turned out to be 72 Lei Long Way. Now, if we just step back, ladies and gentlemen, and again, according to my book, which I have actually published, and you can get it from all the major bookstores, including Kinokuniya, this property was bought by Soilbuild on 27th of May 2015. The buy price, 97 million. Now, just 2 years ago, when they sold it, they were sold at a price of 34.06 million. Now, you probably think this way, right? Because the loss is huge, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, how can one probably lose this much, $63 million, on a 97 million property? Hello, this property is in Singapore, you know? It has waterfront view some more, you know? Right? So the huge percentage loss is actually 65%, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? And mind you, okay, if my records are right, I think this is the single maximum loss sustained by any REIT in any property investment since the REIT market started way back in 2002. Okay, now it's also interesting and glaring in the proposed buyout, because you can see that the Australian properties which come under Soilbuild REIT currently, which the company have acquired and have been acquiring on a rapid spree, you know, in the last 2 years, are no longer part of the Australian assets, because it will be bought over by Blackstone, its other company, right? So what painful lessons is actually being held up? Okay, in fact, most of the painful lessons, as well as forewarn earnings on REITs that will not perform, who are what we call value traps in my book, okay, is in there, okay? And in my book, it actually distills the teachings that I've given to GCP Global students who have been attending our classes regularly for the last 31 years. I'm grateful to Zhao Bao, Lianhe Zhao Bao, who this week, this Monday, actually highlighted, you know, the attributes of my book, you know. So you can see and have a great Christmas and year-end reading on this, okay? Now, principally, ladies and gentlemen, with respect to Soilbuild, and again on page 142 of my book, okay, Making Your Millions in REITs, okay, I've specifically gone on to delve into certain acquisitions, not only for Soilbuild, but for other REITs. Because the key thing I want to protect all my investor students of GCP Global is how do I need and what do I need to know to avoid the pitfalls before Soilbuild price as well as other REITs actually go into a downtrend. Now, in my book, I've actually distilled and shared a lot of other REITs' other experiences and to prepare you for that. So, for example, I've highlighted in my book, again, on page 142, Soilbuild REIT went ahead with its acquisition, for example, of its last Australian REIT, that is 25 Grenfell Street. Now, you notice, ladies and gentlemen, as highlighted in my book on page 136, okay, I've always emphasized that the smart investor should always question the information dished out to justify the acquisition and the price paid. So, for instance, in Soilbuild case, you know, whether when they present the scenario A or scenario B with respect to the proposed then acquisition of 25 Grenfell Street. Now, whether it's A or B, it is actually very clear that DPU will decrease. And yet, ladies and gentlemen, they went and do the acquisition. So, you know, it's quite interesting because, you know, if I may, I just want to read out, you know, what is the Soilbuild Independent Director's recommendation for the proposed privatization. Okay, now, so the chairman and independent ED of Soilbuild manager says that notwithstanding the board and management team's effort to maximize the value of SP unit holders over the years, the unit price have implied a high yield, meaning that it's difficult to make acquisition. Okay, and further impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, just hold on to that thought and see how, to what extent, okay, these statements actually bear themselves out. Now, if you look, ladies and gentlemen, to answer whether if the offer, of course, the board actually recommend that is a credible offer at 55 cents. But if I may, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to ask you to look at this carrying value or the NAV of Soilbuild as of 30th September 2020. Okay, now, and I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, to actually sit back, relax, and do an introspection. Now, how could you possibly be in the space of 2 months, 30th September and 30th September 2020, the same comparable properties, the proposed valuation could possibly drop from 1.366 billion down to the lower end, you know, of the proposed valuation for to support the takeover price at 55 cents. So that is actually a further drop of 1.315 billion. So from 1.366 to 1.315, that's what they are. It's in the presentation material. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, because that will help you answer whether the credible offer at 55 cents actually stands. Okay, now, ladies and gentlemen, it is difficult to lose money in REITs, but in Soilbuild case, unfortunately, that has been the case. Now, for us, other than publishing our book to guide investors to avoid situations like this, we also hold regular classes. And actually, our upcoming class coming up is 9th of January in the new year. So if you feel like, ladies and gentlemen, and you want to help us, you want us to help you to position and to buy into those profitable REITs for the coming year for you to enjoy and in peace the steady dividend that REITs actually dish out, do sign up for our class at GCP Global website, or GCP Facebook, or GCP YouTube page. Okay. Now, in my book, of course, ladies and gentlemen, I am excited on this huge topic that I think will impact REITs. That's what's hot in China REIT market. And I have actually invited my very good friend to address us that day. And he's none other than Mr. Fred Huang, who is the Secretary General of China REITs Alliance. So come to our website and hopefully see you for our class so that you can avoid painful lessons like this on Soilbuild. Thank you, and ladies, and have a good new